Alright guys, I'm out today with Mark, Lindsay's co-worker, and he brought me to some family property out behind an old house. So we're going to hit this for a little bit and I'll show you what we find. Alright guys, I got you here on my first notable find. I got two modern copper pennies and then this guy rang in just like a nickel on the Equinox 800. And that is a nice, ignore the cut on my finger, a nice Eagle infantry button, Civil War. Cuff size, infantry button. Awesome. All right, so Mark called me over. He says he's got his first button.
Ring up is an 87.
87, he's using the AT Pro. And that is nice, thick. You know what? That looks like the back half of a two-piece button. Here, use a toothbrush and see if you can get any of that dirt out.
Guess in the face if it's gone.
Yeah, that could have been an Eagle button like I dug.
Yeah.
That's a little bit bigger, so it probably would have been like a shirt or coat button.
Gotcha.
But it should have a nice back stamp on it. And it'll tell you where the button was made. So that's mid-1800s. Now go find the front of it if it's an Eagle button. Okay, so I didn't get a large scent on video, but I think I have another one here. It was ringing in the copper penny range, and that's a large scent.
Nice.
Oh, there you can see Liberty on this one. That's nice.
The other one wasn't more than 15 feet from there, right?
That was, yeah, behind me, maybe 10 feet. But that one's in much better condition.
What nice.
That was, like, on mine, like a 25... which I thought was like a copper penny.
Yeah.
But it makes sense because this was on edge. Let's see if I can get a date. I think it says 1826. I don't think my phone can make that out. 1826 or 28? Nice. All right, so this is a nice high tone I got in the side yard. We're gonna try and live dig. I know that's probably gonna jinx myself. It's a little tricky with one hand holding the camera. But let's give it a shot. Gonna jinx myself here. It's a nice high tone. Maybe I should guess a clogged quarter again. The last two turned out to be large scents. Okay. Not a great plug because I'm in the roots. Let's see. There we go. Hold on. Move this back a little bit. As I grunt like an old man. Let's find out what she is. She's right there. Oh, did I jinx myself? I did. Glad quarter. There's Washington. What year? Probably when they put these shrubs in, huh? 69? That's, roughly the age of the house that they built here on the old farm field, somewhere in the 60s. All right. So I'm in one little corner of the yard. I dug a nice fancy Tom Backwood design right there, big wire shank, and then a little flat button with a iron back in that hole. And I'm wondering, it must be in a little hot spot. Why are there so many buttons so close? Huh,
They must have been sewing the buttons on in this corner of the field.
Hi guys, I just want to jump in here for a minute. I can't tell you how many times we're out metal detecting and Lindsay calls me over saying she has found some weird thing, a coin or a button, only to find out after I get over there what an amazing find it is, and I hadn't recorded anything. And that's exactly what happened here. Not more than 10 feet from where I dug my buttons and thimble, Lindsay finds a small coin. After a couple swipes with her finger, she can recognize it, and she shows it to me. And I can see a date right on it, plain as day, 1656. It's a King Louis Liard coin from France. And she's recognized it because she'd found one at one of our previous permissions a few years ago. So I got some still photos with it, but unfortunately, I didn't get any video of her digging it. And to that point, it was the oldest thing we found on the property, until you'll see what I dig next. So here's Lindsay's coin, and then you'll see what I find.
All right, so it's a while since I got my last good signal. It was a piece of lead. This time it was down in the hole, almost pinpointer deep. I scooped it out with my hand, and when I saw it in my hand, I tossed it down. I called Lindsay over, because she right there. That is cut copper. She might have some details. I think I see a hair tie. Ooh! Everybody thinks just because they see a hair tie, it's a William, but all of them had hair ties. Gotta see if that says George's or Gilvum's. I think I see an M. There's no M in George's.
So you were just complaining that everybody finds Williams and then you find a William.
I don't know. You tell me. Does that say what I think it says?
Yep.
It's a cut William the
Which you have two of.
I do. I have two cut Williams. Oh, and I dropped it. Where'd it go? I don't see it. Oh, I'm giddy. All right, bye.
And jump in here a minute. I can't tell you how many times we're out metal detecting and Lindsay calls me over saying she's found some weird mother freaking she's calling right now. I'll finish this in a minute.